While a new documentary on Scientology recently aired in America has detailed stunning allegations of physical and psychological abuse, here in Australia, critics say taxpayers are unwittingly subsidising the controversial church. Brian Seymour reports.
This could well be the tipping point for Scientology.
One executive was made to mop up the bathroom floor with his tongue.
It's such a shell game. It's such a sham.
Oscar-winning documentary maker Alex Gibney's new film is called Going Clear. Critics describe it as jaw-dropping and a possible death knell for Scientology. The film includes claims of Scientology's campaign against Nicole Kidman, including tapping her phone and her house to gather information to use against her.
And so I arranged through the Scientology's consigliere to get a private investigator who physically installed a wiretap on her home.
But the most shocking allegations centre on Scientology leader David Miscavige.
I would sit there every night with our scotch and watch and listen to Miscavige comment about Cruise's sex life and what, you know, how perverted he was.
Former Scientologist interviewed in the film alleged Miscavige is a violent, rage-filled abuser who oversees a regime of brutality and control. Originally from Adelaide, Mike Rinder was the group's global spokesman. He claims Scientology leader David Miscavige attacked him and others.
You have been assaulted by Miscavige.
Many times. Many times. Perhaps more than anybody else.
Here in Australia, the activities of Scientology are funded by you and me. Every Australian taxpayer is in effect subsidising the activities of the Church of Scientology, and when you consider its victims, you really need to ask why.
Independent Senator Nick Xenophon led the world in condemning Scientology when, in 2009, he gave this speech in federal parliament.
Scientology is not a religious organisation. It is a criminal organisation that hides behind its so-called religious beliefs. These victims of Scientology claim it is an abusive, manipulative, violent and criminal organisation, and that criminality is condoned at the highest levels.
Alex Gibney's film really puts Tom Cruise on the spot.
Tony Ortega is a former editor of The Village Voice. For 20 years from his New York base, he's written about Scientology. He's also in the documentary.
I mean, I walked out of that film really surprised at how hard it hits Tom Cruise. It's going to be difficult for him not to say something.
Scientology was founded in the 1950s by pulp science fiction author L. Ron Hubbard. The film reveals documented proof that he lied about being a war hero, also that he joined in black magic sex rituals with a man named Jack Parsons.
Parsons had a mansion in Pasadena. They would have ceremonies, and they were seeking some sort of goddess figure that he could impregnate in order to create the Antichrist.
I won't be mourning the passing of Scientology if it moves out of Australia.
You walk out of this theatre with two questions in your mind. Why does Scientology still have tax-exempt status, and when are the celebrities going to speak out?